This video is about the carry select adder. It is an adder used in microprocessor when you want to sacrifice area to get an advantage in speed. The basic building block of any adder is the full adder, which allows us to add three numbers. We can design the full adder in this way and consider a T-sum and T-carry as delays. Connecting four full adders in this way, we build the so-called 4-bit ripple carry adder. It is an adder very simple, but as you can see, for having a stable result in the output, we have to wait that the carry in propagates till the last full adder. The formula of the delay of the ripple carry adder is this, assuming T sum longer than T carry. As you see, there is a linear relation with the number of bits, so as the number of bits increase, the delay increases. For example, with 64 bits, the delay can be too much for our needs. In particular, if you think that the adder is a fundamental element used in all binary mathematical operations. Indeed, it is used in subtraction, multiplication, and division, and many other ALU operations, as increment and decrement by one. So let's see how to overcome or at least reduce the carry propagation issue. The basic idea is double down the number of full adders, connecting the input carry in a case to 0 and the other to 1. This way we have two 4-bit ripple carry adders. And here we have the sum if the carry in is 0, and here the sum if the carry in is 1. Here we have the carry out of the blocks, which arrive after 4 T carry or N T carry in general, while the delay of the last sum S3 is this one here. Now, by means of multiplexer, we select the right result from the right ripple carry adder. If C in is equal to 1, we select the ripple carry adder with the 1 as carry input, otherwise we select the 0 line. For the carry out also, we select the rise C4 through a multiplexer acting by the carry in. Here we draw this block in more compact way. Till now we don't see any advantage in respect to the delay of the ripple carry adder, but let's see a 16-bit adder built in this way. The first block is a 4-bit ripple carry adder, but from the second block on, we see the carry select block. Let's start the timing from the moment in which all the input bits A, B, and C in arrive. After 40 carry, C4 is ready as control bit of the multiplexer of the second block. The bit C4 selects the right line of full adders, whether it is the 1 or the 0 line. When C4 arrives, the sums of lines 1 and 0 of all blocks are ready on the input of the multiplexer. Indeed, after 40 carry, all these sums are ready. For having the sums S4 to S7 stable, we must additionally wait for the delay of the multiplexer. So the total time for having S4 to S7 is 40 carry plus T max. The bits from S8 to S11 are ready and stable after another multiplexer time, so after 40 carry plus 2 T max. So the S12 to S15 bits and C out arrive after another T max, so after 40 carry plus 3 T max. So in general, we say the total delay is kt carry plus p minus 1 t max, where k is the number of bits of a block, n the total number of bits, so p equals n over k is the number of blocks. So if we compare the total delay of this circuit with that of the ripple carry adder, we see we have always a linear relation with n number of bits, but the slope in the carry select adder is t max over k, and that of the ripple carry adder is t carry, so it is bigger. Something similar happens in the carry skip adder, about which I leave a link in the description. But this is not enough, because we still see an inefficiency we can address. The inefficiency is this: if we see the last block, it spends 40 carry doing the sum, and for 30 carry is doing nothing but waiting. So, in order to exploit this time, we could put in the last block more full adders than the previous block. The same for the third block. We wait 2 tmax doing nothing, so we can put here more full adders than the previous block. If we assume that tmax is equal to tcarry, we can design the n bits in the following way. We put k full adders in the first block and k plus 1 in the second, because the second is waiting a tcarry more. Therefore, since each block weighs a tick array more than the previous one, we put a full adder more than the previous one. We obtain this series where p is the number of blocks, but this time p is different from n over k because the blocks have a different number of bits. So we ended up with a circuit like this, where the carry out of the first block arrives after 2 tick carry, and this is the time the 2 full adders of second block take for calculating the carry out, so after another tick carry, we have the sum and the carry out of the second block. But 3 tick carry is the time the third block needs to have the carry out ready for the multiplexer, so after 4 tick carry, we have the sum and the carry out stable from the third block, and so on. So the total delay is 6 tick carry. In general, the delay is k tick carry plus p minus 1 tick max, where k is the number of bits of the first block and the p is the number of blocks. This is not so different from the delay we found when we divide equally the bits in the blocks, but this circuit has its advantage when we have many bits. For example, in the 64 bits case, we can design the full adders and the blocks in two ways. On the right, we have blocks of equal size, so the delay is given by this formula, and in the current case of 64 bits, the delay is this. On the left, we have the more efficient arrangement, where starting from blocks of 2, we arrive to blocks of 9. We have a total of 11 blocks. The general formula is this one, and in the 64 bits case, this is the result. So in the case of tmax equals tcarry, we have 12 versus 15 in favor of the smart arrangement, but we have to add that tmax is generally a bit less than tcarry, so we save even more time. Now we want the general formula for getting the right number of blocks for a given n number of bits. We assume tmax equals tcarry, and we see that in the first block we have k bits, so n is equal to k plus other k bits in the second block, plus k plus 1 bits in the third block, and so on, till the end of the blocks. In total, we have p blocks, so the last term of the numerical series is k plus p minus 2. We can write the series in this other way, grouping k. We note that we have the series which sums the natural numbers up to p minus 2, so we can write it in a more compact way. We know that this series has this result. And since p is usually larger than 2 and k, which by the way is 2 in our case, we can approximate at this, so n is equal to p square over 2. This means that p is equal to the square root of 2n. So let's check the formula in the two cases we talked about. N equals 16 and n equals 64. If n is equal to 16, then p is equal to 5.6. And we took 5 blocks, but the approximation is not so good because p is not so bigger than 2 and k. If we assume n equals 64, we have p equals 11.3. And indeed, we saw previously we designed 11 blocks for our smart arrangement. Replacing p with the square root of n, we get the equation of this kind of carry select adder. And you see that for high value of n, we have an advantage in the carry select adder with a progressive increase in the bits of the blocks, because the relation this time is with the square root of n and not linear. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.